We would like to acknowledge that Beatrice Strong Public School is located on the traditional territory of the Mississauga First Nations.
Morning, Beatrice Strong. Today is Tuesday, May 7th, 2019, day two. Please stand for O Canada in a moment of silence. Please be seated. Here are today's announcements. This announcement from Mrs. Rice. We will be having three-pitch practice after school today. Here's an announcement from Mrs. Stark. Don't forget our Jump Rope for Heart event is on Friday, May 17th. Help us reach our $4,000 fundraising goal. Do you have any friends or relatives that wish to donate but live far away? Send them an email with a link to your online personal donation page. Hashtag Jump Rope for Heart. Here's an announcement from Ms. Simmons. Popcorn will be for sale Friday at First Nutrition Break by the office. $1 per bag. Flavors will be announced later in the week.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to Amelia and Mr. Shirk's class. Hope you have a great birthday, Amelia. Here's the quote of the day.
This is our quote for the day. Don't just read the easy stuff. You may be entertained by it, but you will never grow from it. A quote from Jim Rohn.
Now for our mindful moment.
One of the most challenging parts of meditation is what's sometimes called the dark side of the mind. These are the thoughts and fantasies that we'd rather didn't appear in the mind. Whether they're exciting, violent, vengeful, or maybe even sadistic in nature. We might think we shouldn't be experiencing them. But these thoughts are perfectly natural, and there's obviously no need to act on them. But why do they seem to appear more often once we begin to meditate? Well, typically, we go through our day with quite a heavy filter on the mind, blocking out these thoughts that we don't like, either habitually or intentionally. When we block them out habitually, we're unaware that it's even taking place. We're just so caught up in our day-to-day thinking. But by meditating, we're creating more space in the mind. So it's not that there are more of these thoughts, we just see them more clearly. But when we're blocking them out intentionally, we already see the thoughts clearly, but we're resisting them, perhaps fearful of what they say about us as a person. But what meditation shows us is that we're not our thoughts. So there's no need to judge them, to identify with them. We see that they don't make us a mean person, a terrible person, a twisted person. And it's through this process that we discover peace of mind, allowing thoughts to come and go, at ease with the mind, exactly as it is.
Thank you. I'm Waylon.
I'm Tucker.
And have a great day, Beatrice Strong!
Play, 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 and the heat is on.